Everyone, I'm Ankur Singh, a legal intern at Lexis & Company. In this video, I'm going to talk about preamble of the Constitution. As the language given in preamble of the Constitution is, "We the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, republic, secular, democratic, and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic, and political liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith, and worship, equality of status and opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation in our Constituent Assembly this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt and enact and give to ourselves this Constitution." Preamble, and I am going to discuss some judgments related to it. Whenever a law comes, before that, objective of law comes out. Preamble ensures the objective of Constitution. Justice Subba Rao said, "Preamble mentions the main ideals and aspirations of the Act." In the case of Ray Beriberi versus Union of India, 1960, Supreme Court says preamble is not part of Constitution. Supreme Court says preamble can be driving force of the Constitution, but it is not considered as an essential part of the Constitution. Without it, there will be no difference in the basic objective of the Constitution. This is neither the source of giving power to the government, nor it is a source of to prevent or control or to curtail this power in any way. Importance of the preamble is only when language of Constitution is ambiguous. But in case of Keswananda Bharti versus State of Kerala in 1973, Supreme Court overruled his judgment given in Ray Beriberi case. And Supreme Court says preamble is the part of Constitution in an ordinary act, purpose is not given as much importance as preamble should be given in Constitution. Preamble has great importance in interpretations of articles of Constitution. Justice Sikri said, "No official evidence has been presented in favor of this view that what is true about powers is also true about prohibitions, and in many cases limitation arises on the basis of objective." Further says in this case that preamble of our Constitution is very important, and Constitution should be interpreted according to the ideals contained in it. In case of Arun Rai versus Union of India 2002, Supreme Court says secularism has positive meaning to it, and according to it there should be knowledge of all religions and there should be feeling of respect towards them. Justice Sri Dharmadhikari said preamble and article 25-30 and part 4A is a secular word is inserted during the tenure of 50 years of Constitution, its meaning has was considered neutral and disregarded for all religious, but with this we failed to remove the mutual misunderstanding among the people of all religions. Therefore, we have to take positive meaning of secularism, and according to which citizens should be made aware on of religious so that they can develop a sense of respect for each other. Now the question is preamble is amendable under article 368 of Constitution. In case of Keswananda Bharti versus State of Kerala, central government submits that preamble is a part of Constitution. Thus, preamble can also be amended under Article 368. It is said by the appellant that power given by the Constitution in Article 368 is limited, and preamble itself restricts this power to amend the Constitution. Preamble includes the basic structure of the Constitution, and it cannot be destroyed by amendment, because if any word is omitted from it, there is a fear of collapse of basic structure of the Constitution. Give the judgment that preamble is an essential part of Constitution. It can be amended, but Supreme Court also clarifies that that part of preamble will not be amended which is related to the basic structure. Thus, it is clear that preamble can be amended, but no words can be taken out of it. Such changes will not be made, which is against the basic structure of the constitution. Basically, in this video, I want to say preamble is the essential part of the constitution. It can be amended without destroying the basic structure of the constitution. Hope you understand the concept of preamble and things related to it. Thank you.